the carry. Gain of about 4 or 5 yards, just falling forward, and that's that big burst from that offensive line.
Colts blowing through the defensive line of the Athens Redhawks right now. Down to a minute 30 left in the third quarter. 14-7, Athens still leads it, but they're hanging on by a thread.
You can just see how much they're just blowing out that line. That was a gain of about 7 yards for Dawood, and all he did was just fall forward. The line carried him through. Dawood the tailback, again, this time cuts through, leaping, and he has a first down and more inside the 15-yard line.
This kid is running like his life depends on it now. The whole team is fired up. They've rallied around Jeff Dawood as he is leading his Troy Colts towards another score.
Travis Pendry coming out now. He was a fullback in there on the last play. And now number 33 is in there. Mike Maddy is fullback. So power eye again. They used it last drive. They're going to use it again. Dawood cutting outside. Not much room that time as the Redhawks cut him down.
This time the Redhawk defense read the power eye, strung it out. There must have been an adjustment while the offense was on the field by the defensive coaches. And they said we're going to bring up the defensive back a little quicker and try and string it out when they go to that power eye and overload on the left side.
The wind is blowing very strongly in toward the Redhawks, so that might be why the kick didn't go as far and the passes have not been in favor of the Redhawks in this quarter. But it'll be a big fourth quarter, I guarantee you. Eye formation again, power eye. Dawood, shirt tackled, and I mean shirt tackled as he was ripped down by number 25 on the defense.
Dawood was a little slow getting to the hole that time. His blockers were out in front of him, but one man got a hand on the shirt, and that was it.
Cloutier on the tackle, and that will end the third quarter of play, a very fast third quarter, as the Troy Colts dominated, running the ball and running that clock out. 14-7, the Troy Colts come back.
And here's a look at it. Again, the power eye left. Dawood a little bit behind his blockers. He was kind of slow. Good tackle in there by number 25, Tim Cloutier. Comes up fired up, and it's going to be a big third down when we start the fourth quarter. Troy Colts are dominating the line of scrimmage right now, deep in Troy Athens territory. I think they're on the 10-yard line. The Colts have really shown a lot of guts coming back the way they have this second half.
14-7.
I think Troy Athens had the ball for only one possession in that entire third quarter. Give a lot of credit to the possession type offensive line that is creating holes for Troy here today, in the second half, I should say.
This is what head coach Jeff Keller had in mind for the first half, but it didn't work out that way. First and 10, power eye again. Or rather, I'm sorry, third and 7. And close to a first down.
What a play call that was. They lined up in a power eye left again. The whole defense moved over to that left side to try and stop him. This time the running back went to the right and they got about 6 yards. It'll be fourth and a yard.
Fourth and one now.
Oh, what a big play this is. Troy Athens trying to stay fired up as they try and hold back the Colts.
The Redhawks dig in. Dawood has been dominant here in the second half. He's been gaining all the yardage. Let's see if he gets 1 yard here.
He
does.
He did.
First down for the Colts, first and goal.
Once again, it was the power left. Excellent blocking on the line. The running backs opened a slight hole, and that's all Dawood needed to get the first down. It is first and goal for the Troy Colts.
The first half just totally dominated by the Redhawks. Now they have some work to do as the Colts have
just been
bearing the ball on these power eyes.
Super blocking all along the line of scrimmage. Dawood got the ball and did the job.
Same formation again and the same man again. Dawood dives.
And this time there's a flag on the play.
I think it's
going to be holding on number 99, Scott Maniscalco.
That's going to hurt. It's going to drop them back instead of a first and goal from the 4. It's going to drop them back to a, first and 9, second and 9.
you could see on the play that Maniscalco was just standing there. He didn't execute his block very well, and they called the hold on him. You don't get to see it on that replay.
He would have been down at about the 1 yard line.
Holding offense, first down.
This changes things a little bit.
So first and nine coming up now.
Nope, first and goal from the 14 yard.
From the 14, okay, they were at the four. Drop them back 10 from the 14.
And I'm sure they'll stay on the ground here.
Dowd cuts outside and strung out. And hit there by number 23 defensively, Joe Capozzoli. Capozzoli on a big play.
That time, instead of power eye left, they were power eye right. Didn't fool anybody. The entire Athens defense was over to make the tackle. And Dowd slipped away from a couple of them, but Capozzoli came up and made a good tackle. The one that counted.
Second and 15 now. 10:22 left in the ball game.
Let's see if they don't pitch the ball left this time.
The Colts have run into a wall as the Red Hawks defense tightens up now. Dowd straight up the middle. Nothing.
Third and goal from the 12.
They might have to settle for a Kenya field goal if this play does not work. It's not what they want to do, but they're going to have to.
And Jeff Keller's got to come up with something. He's going to call a timeout and talk about it with his quarterback. But the coaching staff at Troy has got to come up with some kind of play other than that power in order to get the first down here. Actually, they have no first down to get the touchdown. And I'll tell you what might not be a bad call. To the wide side of the field here, run that quick pass, sort of a screen setup that they ran for the first down a little while ago. Yes, it was.
But 20 yards to go.
Yes, sir. Actually, it was third and 14.
Third and 14, they got a bulk of, they got what, 13 yards?
Yes, they did.
And then went on a fourth down to get the first down. They got to hand it to the Red Hawks for stopping the Colts as the Colts had the momentum.
Yeah, the Troy Athens Red Hawk defense really sucked it up and stopped them when they had to, but they still got a little tester left, as we say.
And we mentioned the wind early. If we get a shot of the flag, we can see how hard the wind is blowing in towards Kenya. So that's going to be a big factor. There is a flag, and you can see it's blowing pretty hard. And this will affect definitely the Colts if Kenya has to come in to kick a field goal.
No question about it.
Power eye again. They're going to run? No, they're going to pass. Incomplete, and they're going to have to go for a field goal here.
It was a nice, safe pass. He made sure that he threw it to the outside in case there was a defender on the inside. He didn't want it picked off. And boy, I tell you, Kenya has his work cut out. This is going to be a 40-yard field goal.
We showed you the wind, and it's even picked up now. The flag is almost straight out.
A 40-yard field goal against the wind.
Scott Kenya, we'll see what this guy is made of. What a leg he's got. We saw him boom the kickoff here to open up the ball game, or rather to... We saw him boom the one after they scored the touchdown. Kenya, it is up and a beauty.
No good.
But it is no good. The wind blew it off to the side. And that's how important that wind is going to be here in the fourth quarter.
You made a good point, David. And Kenya booted it left, and that is a big miss. I'll tell you what hurt him. That holding penalty absolutely killed him. Mistakes will do it to you every time.
They had the ball inside the five-yard line, a first and goal situation at the four, and instead it knocked them all the way back to the 14.
So the Troy Colt defense will have to play some big ball right now and come up with some kind of stop so they can get the offense the ball back. Otherwise, Troy Athens is going to run away with this one.
The Red Hawk defense holds, and they come back now with an eye formation. 2 minutes at the top of the screen. Handoff, and cutting up is Groff with a big gain on a first down. And you can tell the missed field goal means a lot to the Colts because you count on a guy like Kenya to kick those But then look at how strong that wind's blowing, and you can tell it just blew it off to the side.
You can even hear it whistling through the microphones right now. So that was good offensive line blocking on the right side of the Red Hawk offensive line. They opened up a nice hole. Groth got about 3 or 4 yards.
It'll be second and 5. Groth the tailback. Cloutier the fullback. Cloutier leads the way. Groth cuts outside.
Going to leave him about a 3rd and 3.
Short of a first down. 3rd and 3 coming up. 8:48 left on the clock. Time very important now for both teams.
This is a big third down play because you know they're not going to go for it on fourth. Here's a replay. Gives it up to Cloutier. He just follows his blocking. Gets about 3 yards on it. Good tackle. It's a pass.
Pass and off the fingertips. Now, number 87, Phil Mason, the split end. They have not gone his way too much. They've got the good coverage on him over there, the Colts do. And a big series of downs right here if the Redhawks can't do anything with it.
And I don't think that the tight end was ready for that one. Went right out, you know, was in his hand.
A little bit high.
But his head wasn't really looking at the ball.
Yeah.
That's tough to do.
3rd and 2 now.
4th and 2.
Or 4th and 2. The scoreboard I'm looking at it, but the marker on the side says 4th. Bad snap.
Good kick.
But a good kick to compromise. Here's Farwell. Cuts outside and a big block.
He's going all the way.
Farwell. One man to beat. And he's down inside the 10-yard line. And the Colts come back on a big run back by Scott Farwell.
And you saw Scott Farwell do it on a punt a little while ago to set up a good scoring drive. And here you see him again, this time taking all the way down inside the 10-yard line. What super field position for the Troy Colts. Here's the kick. It was a bad snap, a good kick. Farwell catches it at about his 40-yard line.
Watch the block here, though, by Gawan. That was right there.
On the tight end.
A big block right there, sprung him loose.
And he had the seam on the right side, finally tackled at about the 8. And here's Gawan with the ball. And he's thrown for a loss, but he gets away.
Gawan.
Running for the end zone, touchdown! But there's a flag on the play.
Flag on the play, who was it on?
Oh my, it looks like it's going to be holding again on the Colts.
Gawan had come towards us and then cut back around the other way. And it's another holding call. And Maniscalco is really upset.
That's the second time Maniscalco has been called for that foul. No excuse.
Holding, offense. First down.
We don't know who did it, but whoever did it, it's hurt them twice now. They were inside the 4 or the 5 yard line the first time. They didn't score because of the wind. Now it knocks them back even further. They were inside the 10 yard line. Now they're just inside the 20.
And it's very difficult to pass now because the wind is against you. Look at Jeff Keller. He's really hot about that penalty.
So it's gonna be a first down over again. A first down over again. First and 20, first and goal from the 20.
First and
Capozzoli
goal from the
coming
20,
off
that
again.
Is tough.
He was carried off earlier.
With the ankle, with the leg cramp.
And he's hurting. I formation in the backfield.
You can hear the crowd. Let's go, Colts. Let's go, Colts.
We want to gain half this back here on this first play, and this way we can get some running room. Back to pass. Marr, and dropping it.
Maniscalco.
Maniscalco right in his hands. Right in the numbers. A tough play for Scott.
He wanted to run before he caught the ball, and you youngsters out there watching this game, you've got to make sure you haul it in before you get the feet going. Doesn't work the other way, as you just saw.
The big tight end was wide open.
Wide open.
Short pattern.
And when he gets rumbling, he can move. He had some room.
He He had a defender right next to him, but the numbers, the pass hit him right on the numbers. Second and 20. Goal from the 20. The pass complete to Farwell and out of bounds at about the 10-yard line.
Nice catch over there by Farwell. Same kind of pattern we've seen all night, just the quick flip. That on a down and out, and he turned it into a 10-yard gain. So it's third and goal from the 10 for the Troy Colts. Here's a replay. The fake inside. Maurer zips it outside on the down and out. Farwell for 10 yards.
The ball just outside the 10-yard line, the 11.
Do they go back in the air?
Yeah, they have to. They have to.
You're right. Maurer. Here comes the rush.
The freshman is sacked. The Redhawks come up with a big play. 43 and 66 defensively.
Don Mason on the tackle and Joe Samko.
So now another attempt. The wind dying down a little bit and now is picked up again. So it is swirling out there.
This time, last time it was a 40 yarder. This is a 35 yarder.
Into the wind. Very important. He knows that the wind is blowing to his left. That's the way it blew it last time. So he knows how to make the correction now. Kenya to kick. It is up. It is
good.
Good. A big kick for Scott Kenya. He made the corrections with the wind and kicked it right down the middle.
A 35 yarder, and he made it by plenty. What a tremendous kicker this Kenya is. And had he made the last one, instead of the score being 14 to 10 right now, it would be 14 to 13. And again, in both instances, first and goal from inside the 5, the first time, inside the 10, the second time, two holding penalties have cost this team 14 points. Now they only got 3 out of the possible 14-point opportunity that they had. And that's the way it is, 14 to 10 right now in favor of Troy Athens, and their defense has hung on each time that Troy has gotten the ball in good field possession. We've got about 6 minutes left.
Fine job defensively. Scott Kenya, there he is, the senior kicker, putting it through for the Troy Colts.
It's a little too early for an onside kick. Kenya will just try and boot it as far as he can.
Probably get some height on this one with the wind blowing it back and get good coverage for the Colts. He does
short
get height,
kick.
But it's short. The Colts there to cover, and that is like an onside kick. They almost got it back.
Exactly. That was a live ball. Had they not fell on it, that would have been a Troy Colts ball at about the 25-yard line. But the Redhawks retain possession, and they start out from their own 25-yard line. With about, I don't think the clock ever started.
So the defense did their job for the Redhawks. Now the offense has to do something. They have to kill some of that clock off and get it in the end zone.
No question, but that's tough to do against this Troy Colt defense. It's like a different ball game from the first half.
And it is, 14 to 10 the score, 5:40 left in the ball game. DeBrinket, the quarterback. Hands off the first man through the fullback.
Nothing.
Cloutier hit at the line of scrimmage and dropped.
And if you like football, you're enjoying this game. What a contest we have had here tonight. Troy Athens leading it 14 to 10 here in the fourth quarter.
Second and 8.
Pass.
DeBrinket.
Got hit.
Under pressure, hit, and complete, and one man to beat. Look out, Pepazzoli, as the pursuit catches up to him at about the 42-yard line.
Capozzoli brought down by Mike Payne. But
Capozzoli is in pain, excuse me. Look, had he not been hurt, he might have gone all the way.
Right, he's been hobbled by that leg cramp. They're calling for Niehaus on the sideline to bring in the next play. Here's the call. He just sent the player in, and now he's going to signal it in with his hands to his quarterback, DeBrinka.
Capozzoli, a great reception and a great job by DeBrinka to just get that ball off.
What a big play. And they're not supposed to have big play capabilities at Troy Athens.
Ha! High formation. The handoff to Groff. And a shoe tackle just hung on by the shoestring. Maniscalco on the tackle.
Maniscalco hit him hard. You'd go down too. I'll tell you something. What you mentioned it a second ago, but let's talk about it a little more. What composure by Joe DeBrincat to get that ball off. He was under tremendous pressure, got hit as he was releasing the ball. Capozzelli made the catch and turned it into a big gainer.
Joe DeBrincat, the senior quarterback, getting Capozzelli for a big first down. Second and eight now for the Redhawks, as they have to come up with a score here to put the pressure on the Colts. Complete to Phil Mason. And a big gain out there, and hit out of bounds. The Colts are playing fired up.
Yep.
But the Redhawks are coming back offensively, and they have to do something.
I think
the clock and get some points on the board.
They got 5 yards on that carry. But I'll tell you what that big play does. It takes field position away from the Troy Colts should they get the ball back. Here's a look at the last play. Just a quick out. Again, a good catch that by the other Mason. We're back to live action.
Third and short, and the Colts stop them.
They've seen that play all night long, the Colt defense has, and they were ready for it. Just the simple belly play to the left of the left tackle, and they read it perfectly and stopped them. Fourth down now.
Fourth and two. Groff on the carry, didn't get anywhere.
Can they be going for it?
They're doing it. They're going for it. They have to.
I disagree.
They might want to bury him deep, but if you do punt, the wind is at your back. It could blow right into the end zone. You only get it at the 20 anyway, so there's a difference of maybe about 10 yards. Groff on the carry, first down.
And Troy Athens,
and
coach,
that'll buy you some more time as 2:25 left on the clock. Should Troy get it back, the pressure will definitely be back on their shoulders.
John Walker looks like a genius. He called that fourth down play, knew exactly what he wanted. He ran the third down play to the left side, came back to the right side for the fourth down play, and here it is. Good line blocking. There's the fullback, makes the big block, and you see easy pickings for the first down.
It was Cloutier's block that sprung him for the first down. First and 10. Ball inside the 30-yard line at about the 28.
2 minutes left in the game.
And now all the Redhawks want to do is just run the ball. Run the ball and run that clock out. Jeff Keller has to use his timeouts here.
But I don't think he has. I think he's only got one left.
So the Redhawks have played a very smart game here in the second half.
Official timeout. There's a problem with some equipment. There you see the replay of the last one.
About a 4 yard gain for Groff. It'll be second and six coming up. The band is in the end zone. I hope they don't run out on the field like that Stanford game
that we saw
2 years ago. The wind is whipping up, and hey, they might get 3 points out of this and put it out of reach. Well, or at least a tie, because the wind is going their way. Jeff Niehaus has been a pretty good kicker in the last three games. And with the wind at his back, we could add him maybe about another 5 yards. It is Groff, the tailback. Wrestling for some yardage.
And I don't understand why the clock is still running. He was knocked out of bounds. He was stopped out of bounds. That's a...
And you can see that Jeff Keller is down on the field saying that should have stopped.
Absolutely.
But the referees did not see it that way. He did not stop the clock. Let's see if he does go out of bounds.
Watch, the knee doesn't go down. He's running outside. Oh, we lost the replay.
Okay.
34 seconds left.
Oh,
and this game is history, ladies and gentlemen.
And you can see the fans coming out on the sidelines. They're ready to take the field.
It's crazy here. The Troy Athens Redhawks.
Groff on the carry, wrestles for some yardage, and that'll do it. It's over.
The Troy Athens Redhawks have upset the undefeated Troy Colts, 14-10. That's it. 9 seconds. 8 left. The clock counting down. The score is Athens 14, Troy nothing. And this game is over.
The final score, 14-10, and the Redhawks have won the bragging rights for the city of Troy as they defeat the Colts, who are 8-0. Coming into the game, they are now 8-1. And the Redhawks go to 7-2. You can see how much this game means. Not only the players, but the fans.
I'll tell you, there's nothing that we can say. Nothing we can say at all that you don't see on the faces of these elated fans as their Redhawks dominated from the opening kickoff, slipped a little in the third quarter, and hung on to beat the Troy Colts 14-10. And as the teams and the fans make their way from the field, you can see the disappointment.
That's not disappointment. That's tears of joy there. I think it's what it is.
I think she's got
cold.
I think she's got a boyfriend that plays for Troy.
There
you
coach,
see.
John Walker.
And he earned this one tonight.
We'll be back to wrap it up from Troy Athens High School after these messages.
From politics to park events, Oakland Weekday News Brief is your source for local information. We deliver news that you need to know. Whether it's news from within or outside of the county, we're covering it because it affects you. Join Dave Zorn and me 6 minutes to the hour, Monday through Friday on Channel 137 during CNN Headline News.
Freedom is shining on the Redhawks right now as they are free to declare that they are the Troy champions.
What a super game we saw here tonight. Troy Athens came out and in unfamiliar fashion threw the ball, mostly ran a few times to get key first downs on third and fourth down situations, and led 14-0 at the half. The Troy Colts came back in the second half, seemed to dominate completely, came back with 10 unanswered points, but the Athens Redhawks hung on at the end of the game to win it. There you see some of the press talking to Troy head coach Jeff Keller, certainly disappointed, but it was a terrific effort on the part of both teams tonight, Dave.
Yeah, I think there are no hard feelings. Jeff Keller, we talked to him, he knew that he had his hands full going up against this tough Red Hawk team.
You're absolutely right. He said he would rather play a team that doesn't play
exactly
possession type offense.
And those words that he said stuck out most in my mind when he said that, when you asked him, what kind of team would you rather play? And he said, I'd rather play a team that doesn't pass like this team does.
And the Athens Red Hawks rallying around the team support. That's the thing that they said coming into the game. Yeah, we don't have Sosnowski, but we don't need him because we're a team and we play that way and every man does his job, and that's the way to win football games.
Let's wrap up the ball game for you. The scoring came in the second quarter. The first scoring did against that man, Jeff Keller. Very dejected Jeff Keller, but a very proud one as well, as his team has gone 8-1 this year. In the second quarter, the second play, DeBrinket hit Don Mason on a quick slanting pattern in the end zone. The extra point was good. They led 7-0. Then Van Groff took the ball on a 1-yard run. The extra point was good. It was 14-0. Then we came back in the third quarter, a 1-yard run, as the Troy Colts totally dominated that third quarter. It was a 1-yard run by Dawood as he took over on the offense and just totally dominated the defense of the Red Hawks. 7-14, the Troy Colts were on their way back. Then in the fourth quarter, they had a big play down inside the 4-yard line, a holding call, brought them back. A missed field goal by Kenya, and that hurt the Colts. And then they came back in a big run by Farwell to get inside the 10-yard line, and then another holding call. They had to settle for a field goal again.
But in both instances, you have to give credit to that Troy Athens defense. They had their backs against the wall, and each time they were able to come up with the big plays and stop the Troy Colts from scoring.
They had to settle for that field goal. The score was 14-10, and all it took was Athens to just run the clock out, and that's what they did. They came up with some big first downs, especially the pass to Joe Capozzoli here.
And what a pass by Joe DeBrinket to get the ball off, because he was under tremendous pressure, got hit as he was letting it go. Capozzoli made the catch, got the first down, brought him about 40 yards down the field, and that was the key to wrapping it up here at Troy Athens.
Well, that does it for our regular season here for UCTV Sports. Did a fine job all year. Tonight, our cameraman, Donald Anthony, who's been there all year, Ed Stizza, Mike Tatimer, and helping us out here, Mr. Dennis Moore tonight, also on camera. Cedric Sawyer doing a fine job on graphics, our TD, Ken Taylor, our director, Ken Taylor, and of course, our engineer.
Engineers.
Is Pat Collar. Our audio man, Dan McGillis, did a fine job, too. So, from Troy Athens High School for the regular season, we'll see if we can bring you some high school playoff action coming up in the future. For Mark Unger, Mark, it's been a pleasure. We'll see you in the playoffs, eh?
Yes, sir, David.
All right. This is Dave Zorin. Thank you all of you for watching. Join us next time on UCTV Sports.